Lately, I've been losing sleep.
Start off by the first yearling. He's a little two-year-old colt by Milk It Mick.
I've been praying hard.
He's for every inch the two-year-old. Not overly big, but he's big enough if good enough.
Miracle of Medina gets off the mark at the third attempt for Mark Usher and Leon Canary. Miracle of Medina wins it. Inside the last, it's Miracle of Medina and Silvestre de Souza. Treaty of Paris bearing down late. Miracle of Medina holding on gutsily. Miracle of Medina from Treaty of Paris.
And it is Miracle of Medina, about a 33-1 chance, made all and took the 14 grand home.
But I'm not that old, young, but I'm not that bold, and I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told.
Furlong to go. Miracle of Medina out in front, not stopping at the moment. Cable Bay in second place with three quarters of a length to find. Miracle of Medina holding on grimly all the way to the line for a shock and a massive win for Mark Usher.
This is a yearling colt by Kaylee at a mare called Ex Donna Giovanna, who was by Mozart. The colt, the sire Kaylee, has been a tremendously successful sire. He's the same colour as this lad. Some people don't like very dark black horses, but Kaylee, who won the Jersey Stakes at Royal Ascot, was exactly the same colour. He was a very good two-year-old, as I say, he won the Jersey Stakes at Royal Ascot, and he's a top-class stallion. The dam, Don Giovanna, was just trained up the road by Jamie Osborne. And this is the second foal. The first one, who hasn't won yet, has been running very well. He's a nice colt, I think he's very athletic, and Caleb comes with a bit of a reputation for Jack the Lads, but they just need plenty of time to settle down. But I'm very, very keen. I was very keen on him at the sales, and he'd been bought by Kevin Noel, the senior, and I thought we were lucky to get him for what we paid for him at the end. So very happy to have him. He was born on February the 29th, so you would hope he would make a two-year-old. So that's the Kaylee out of Don Giovanna, who's by Mozart. So really, he's bred for speed. Kaylee has basically won the 7 furlong Jersey Stakes at Royal Ascot. guys, this is a two-year-old colt by Bahamian Bounty and a maternity ring. I bought him on Friday. I've always been a great fan of Bahamian Bounty, because I trained his mother, Clarentia. She was a great filly for me. She was a group winner, and we sold her for a lot of money. Anyway, she's the dam of this guy's father. Bahamian Bounty has been an extremely successful stallion. He sired winners of over 900 races, and the amount of black type horses just goes on and on. He's a top class stallion. Stands at 10 grand, and he's very commercial. I think this is a smashing little colt. He's got a great little walk on him. He looks every inch a two-year-old. The mare has bred a winner of two races this year, and she is a sister, Eternity Ring, to the top class filly, Love Everlasting. So he's certainly got in the page. He looks tough, he looks strong. He's beautifully balanced little horse. He certainly, I liked him a lot. And a lot of people commented, I bought him for 12 grand, which I thought was, I certainly didn't think I'd get him for that sort of money. And I haven't spoken to High Five Racing yet, but I'd like you guys to have him. But we'll talk about that over lunch, okay? So that's the Bahamian Bounty colt. This is a different type of horse in many respects. He's a two-year-old colt, yearling colt even, by Rip Van Winkle. Out of a mare called Foolish Ambition. He'd certainly make a three-year-old, and he'll probably come along in the second half of his two-year-old career, you would have thought. Anyway, just to tell you, he's born on March the 3rd. Rip Van Winkle is by the champion sire, Galileo. And he was a champion miler in Europe. That's his sire. This is his first crop of youngsters. So he'll either be hot property next year or binned. We'll just have to see. But that's the fickleness of the market at the moment. So the mare was a winner as a two-year-old, this Foolish Ambition. And she was listed placed as a two-year-old as well. The Galileo Danehill cross, this guy being by Galileo and the mare being by Danehill, Foolish Ambition, is a very, very successful cross. So, as far as the bloodlines are concerned, he walks well enough. He's quite a nice horse. He was 20,000, which was amazing, really. For, I mean, some of the Rip Van Winkle fetched £200,000 or £300,000. Last week and the week before. But he's not a forward type. He's going to take quite a lot of time, quite a bit different to the other two. But he's a nice type. He's very well bought, I think. He's owned primarily by Norrell Hire's own Imran Butt. But he might be looking for some partners in the horse. I'm not going to confirm that at the moment. But I'm very fond of him. He's been broken in, he's been very good. But I certainly see him more as a second season project, really, as opposed to a first season project. Although I'm sure he's probably proved me totally wrong by the end of the year. Right.
Good boy.
the lad, two-year-old colt by Avonbridge. He was born on April the 6th. So the reason I bring up the foaling dates, it tends to reflect on sort of kind of time of year when they're liable to run, really, i.e. the earlier foals tend to be maturer, really, basically. He's out of a mare called Ishibi, who's by Ishiguru. You see, he's got quite a bit of growing to do. Avonbridge, he was a decent sprinter. He won the Group 1 Prix de l'Abbé for William Muir and the same owner, John Deere, who owns that very good horse of Roger Charlton's this year. He was a decent sprinter, won the Prix de l'Abbé, and he's side winners of races of over 250 races, and he's got a lot of black type horses as well. So he's certainly a capable stallion. They're all basically, this fella's bred for speed, really. The dam, Ishibi, John Bridger trained her. She was a tough little filly, and she won five times. And this is her first produce. So it'll be interesting how he gets on. And it's interesting, I mean, I've got a friend of mine called Tim Moorhead. We're buying quite a few fairly cheap youngsters. And so we're looking at the other end of the scale as far as the market's concerned. There's not much wrong with this guy. I quite liked him, but he costs £1,000. So it's amazing, isn't it? You know, that's a kind of difference. But he's by a stallion who can produce winners, black type winners, and he's out of a mare that's won five times, and this is her first produce. So, unless I'm seeing something that everybody else can't see something that everybody else is seeing, I thought a grand was. Avonbridge isn't very popular at the moment, but let's say the whole stallion thing is very fickle. So that's him anyway. He's behaving himself. This is a yearling filly. Dave, just take a hand. Back a bit. That's it, right. This is a yearling filly by a horse called Captain Gerard. Captain Gerard just had his first year as a stallion, and he's really upgraded his mares. A lot of horses have won out of, he's produced a lot of winners from some fairly ordinary mares. He was basically a sprinter. This filly was born on April 24th. As I say, Captain Jarrett had a very good first year. Two of the progeny out of the mare. She's had four foals, two of which are winners. Again, she was a very cheap filly, another £1,000 horse. But you know, I think she's very athletic. And on the basis of the partnership, is buying quite a lot of cheap babies and seeing if one of them comes out okay. I'm very pleased with her. She looks an athletic type. She might take a little bit of time to come to herself, but she's by a decent enough stallion, and she's out of a mare's produced a couple of winners. And she's pretty good, athletic, decent walker. So she's probably pretty well bought, but obviously time will tell. Right, this is a two-year-old filly, yearling filly. God, get around there in the end. She's by a new stallion, first season sire, called Fast Company. Fast Company was trained by Brian Meehan. He's a very good two-year-old. He ended up being second in the Dewhurst. Just got beat, got sold to Godolphin. And then disappeared off the face of this earth and has come back as a stallion. His progeny were really well received at the sales, and I think this could have been one of the bargains of the sales. I'd like to think so. She only cost 4,000 in Ireland. I mean, the average, I mean, certainly I saw plenty going 50, 60, 70, 100,000 by her, and I was always drawn to her progeny at the sales. They're great walkers. This filly's a great walker, great athlete, and I'm very, very keen that we've got her. I think they're quite hot, because I've seen a lot of the Fast Companies at the sales, and they seem to behave in that way. But anyway, there she is. Her dam was trained by Luca Cumani. The dam was called Extravagance. The other thing about this filly, she's born on May the 10th, so she'll probably take a little bit of time to come to herself, although she does look quite strong, and I'm sure she's going to be very athletic. The dam didn't win Extravagance, but she was well rated. She was rated in the 90s, so she was probably just one of those horses that was a bit unlucky to win. She's had two foals to race, two two-year-olds to race, and they've both been winners. So that's extremely encouraging. Again, as I say, with his new first season size, he'll either be hot property this time next year or binned. That's the way things are. So, but anyway, looking at the types of horses that his progeny are, I'm sure he'll have a very, very good year. So there she is, by Fast Company, out of Extravagance, a half-sister to two winners. The mare's only just produced two foals. And at £4,000, I felt she was a bargain. She came from Ireland. I bought her in Tats, Ireland. Give me the run round to break in. She's been very good today so far. Little two-year-old yearling filly by Monsieur Bond. She's small, but she's sharp. Very, very quick-looking filly. Just keep her on the look, keep her on the move, Dave, if she wants to just take half turns and that. She's by Monsieur Bond. She's born on February the 29th. She'll be ready to rock and roll early on. She looks very quick and sharp to me. Brilliant walker. And the fact that she's a bit small doesn't bother me two hoots. She's out of a mare called Dazzling Daisy. The sire, Monsieur Bond, you may or may not know, he's a very high class sprinter, and he's sired lots of very good horses, and he's been extremely good with his fillies. You may or may not know that filly of Clive Cox trained, Gilt Edge Girl, won the Prix de l'Abbé, and he's had a lot of good, very good fillies. He's also had horses like Hoof It, who was second at Ascot yesterday. All right, quietly, quietly. Just go quietly with her. Actually, just take her on to lawn. She is quite a character, as you can see. Okay, just lean around on the lawn there a bit, Dave. Keep your occupied. All right, sweetheart. Quietly. There's always one, isn't there? The mare's had one runner and one winner. So, and that's her full sister. So there's a heck of a lot going for this little filly. She's an early foal, by a decent stallion. She's a full sister to a winner. The mare's only one to race. She's getting a little bit cross now because we're separating it from her sister in arms, which is in the box right next to her. But I think she's a cracking walker, very correct. Eligible for the yearling bonus scheme. Lots going for this one. As I say, she'll be a two-year-old through and through.
How much is she worth?
4,500 she costs.
She gone?
Okay, sorry?
Is she gone?
No.
She gone now.
Okay,
This is the last yearling filly, the last yearling. She's by Camacho. Just let her have a little bit of, just that's it, keep it moving around. Right, Camacho, she's born on March the 7th, this filly. Camacho's been around for a while, but he's been a decent stallion. He's had a fabulous 2013. He sired plenty of black type horses. Green Door won the Flying Childers for the Qataris. So he's a decent enough stallion. They tend to like soft ground. And she's from the very good Ballymacall family. That's produced this year, Galileo Rock. I think he was third in the Derby, favourite Washington trained horse. She's bred, she has a lot of stamina in her pedigree. But having said that, she very much looks like a two-year-old. You know, I can see that she'd want six to start to get going. Anyway, she's out of a mare called Love City. Love City was a winner and has bred a winner. As I say, she's by Ballymacall family. It's the Sobel family. They had tremendous stud in Ireland. They've had tremendous success, and that's all her family. But as I say, a lot of stout pedigree. Well, I mean stout, a lot of staying blood in her pedigree. But Camacho, on the whole, is an influence on speed. You know, again, she was bought cheaply for $3,000 at Doncaster. She's eligible for the yearling bonus scheme. And I think, really, considering the way the sales have gone, I'd like to think she's very well bought. It's all very well me saying these things, time will tell. But I'm very glad we did buy her, because I'm sure at a later sale she would have fetched more money. There we are, that's her. She's settled down a little bit now. By Camacho, out of Love City. And there we go.